See you guys on the other side of Warhammer. Whoops, I forgot I still had the game running. No matter, gonna quit it. I forgot I enjoyed the intro. Alright, see you guys on the other side of Warhammer! Woohoo!
It is a dark age, a bloody age, an age of war. The gods are cruel, and we are their playthings. But this is no game. It is ceaseless war, with the old world its prize. Many seek the path to victory, but only one can stand glorious over all. From the Badlands come the orcs and goblins, a green tide of brutal creatures that must be stopped. In Sylvania, the dead rise again. The vampire counts march forth. The mighty dwarf kingdoms, long thought diminished, are resurgent under their high king. And at the old world's heart stands the Empire. Karl Franz must prove worthy of the Warhammer. Then there is chaos. Its corrupting, changing taint despoils all before it. Only the strongest will endure. War is upon us. It is unending.
Sorry for the switch up there again. I apologize, but damn CA for not including a bottleless window. Oh, whoops. Need to adjust this, of course, otherwise you guys can't see it. That was a great intro indeed, Zigcat. Pre-rendered, but still, yeah, it was awesome. It was actually the intro that they used as the announcement trailer for Warhammer Total War, but then with a different overlaid text. Will you do Chaos? No, Chaos was not part of the the poll, because I wanted to start with a settled faction. If you were here, I'm not sure, Zigcat, if you were, but if you were here for the Rome 2 Emperor Edition release stream, which was quite the time ago, I played the Huns because people want to play me, see me play a Horde faction, and I lasted 11 hours. That was the entire stream, 11 hours from start to finish, and I didn't last long with Horde factions. So the thing is, I suck at playing Horde factions, that's one. And two, I don't know this game yet. I don't know the ins and outs, the mechanics of it. So I prefer to start with a settled faction, if that makes sense, before moving on to the Hordes. But I will definitely stream a Chaos playthrough at some point, once I'm more familiar with the game. That is definitely a plan for the near future. Damn, this camera is really really wobbly today. No orcs. Vampire counts actually won the poll that I set out. Wasn't there when the patch came out just after the release, wondering if you have a non-patch version? Because it says you have 1.00. I have the 1.00, it seems so. No, I wasn't there when the patch was here, because I was in America until today. I just received the collector's edition and I installed it. Like 2 hours ago. That's all I did. So, I don't know. There is a patch already. Can I patch it before I support, maybe? Or is that... No. That's just the support thingy. Is it possible to patch this thing? No, wait, because then you guys have to wait. The patch dealt mainly with it. It's fine, it's fine. We're just gonna handle it. I'll patch it after the stream. And if it screws up our campaign, we're just going to deal with it as a test thing. I mean, this stream isn't going to be long anyway, because I have to go home and I have to go to my parents soon and catch up with Game of Thrones together with my dad. So. And book. So the stream won't be long anyway. Just gonna check out some stuff. And with that in mind, I actually want to play a custom battle first. That is the way of things that I do in new Total Wars, is I usually play a custom battle first before jumping into a actual campaign. Just play it, see, usually pitch games is necessary when you stop playing. Exactly. Exactly. I'll deal with that later. So you wanted to see some green skins, Zigcat? Or do you want to see Chaos? I don't mind playing Chaos this battle. Just to check out some Chaos, Zig, if you want. I'll leave it up to you. I can even do Chaos V green skin, so you can see both, if you want. We're jumping into a Vampire Counts campaign, so not really playing that yet. Here we go. Chaos Wastes. Chaos. There you go. You love Chaos. Then we'll do some Chaos. How is that? You can see some Chaos right here. Oh god. Prince Sigvald the Magnificent. There's some Chaos Sorcerers, this Kolek Sun Eater and Archon. Of course I'm going for Kolek. Are you kidding me? Kolek's awesome. I love Kolek. Alright, let's get a wizard in here because I wanna experiment with some magic. I wanna see what the magic does. Let's get some fire in. New to the Warhammer, some characters have selection of mounts available. Selecting one of these icons will assign the chosen mount for the battle ahead. Awesome. Chikun! Thank you for the host, sir. Welcome. I thought of orcs when you talked about horde factions. Doesn't get more hordy than orcs. That's true. And yet, they are a settled faction. Which is interesting. Let's just not put our... Can we put our exalted hero on a Chaos Dragon? No. But we can have a Manticore. Alright. We've got a lot of characters, but I don't care. I want to see the mounts and stuff. Hey, Jakun! What's up? How you doing? Welcome home. It has been quite the holiday indeed. I did the inexcusable thing of spelling the greenskins the wrong way. They are orcs! Orcs. 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 fork. Soup you eat with a fork. Sounds better in Dutch, but never mind. Alright, let's get some Chaos Warriors in here, right? Chaos Warriors. Who doesn't like some Chaos Warriors? We're also getting some Marauders. Of course, because, you know, there are more Marauders than Chaos Warriors in the world. I think according to the lore, I'm not sure, but I think according to the lore, Chaos Warriors are actually very rare. Can you say it in Dutch? Sure. Orik, 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 soep eetje met een vork. It just sounds better. Ooh, chosen great weapons. No, chosen halberds. Chaos chariot, ghoul beast chariot. Ooh, knights. We definitely need knights. You witness anything crazy on your trip? Oh, plenty of stuff, Jakun. Plenty of stuff. I witnessed plenty of crazy things. America is a pretty, pretty crazy country when it comes to crazy stuff happening. I have to admit. Ooh, monsters! We need some monsters. Oh god, we're almost out of funds already. I think I need to up the funds. Can I do that? Do I need to redo it? Can I get some ultra funds so I can just, you know, go crazy? I want the Dragon Ogre Shaggoth. I love Dragon Ogre Shaggoths. And we've got Kolek Sun Eater. I mean, he's the guy. This place scares the crap out of me. Well, it didn't scare the crap out of me, but... ooh, we need a giant. I want to see a little giant lumbering about. I'm not really thinking really tactically, but... eh. I think we need to support the Chaos Knights with some Warhounds, perhaps. And we want to shoot the crap out of some Greenskins with a Hell Cannon. And we'll get a Chaos Spawn to round it out. Alright. So there we go. We've got our big army. Now we need to make an army that's equally as scary for the Greenskins. Let's go with Grimgore, Mr. Grimgore himself. Grimgore Ironhide. Let's give them some magic as well, that's fine. He has a goblin magician. And he has some black orcs, of course, because he needs his bodyguards. Some savage orcs as well. Ooh, some fanatics. Fanatics are always fun. Big ones. I'm not very familiar with the orc army, I have to admit. So, just doing some stuff here. Some archers. That's fine. Savage orc boar boy big guns. That's a mouthful there. Yeah, let's give them a try. Why not, right? I want to say let's add the spider, but... ooh, a chariot, also fine. Oh, there it is. Bam, there's the spider. Oh, wow! Look at that balance of power generated with that Arachnorok spider. It's like, yep, they're stronger now. Have fun. Look at that, every Doom Diver, oh my god. They are already stronger and they don't have a full army roster. Oh, we don't either, but... holy crap, they still have 3,000 funds left and they're already stronger than us. That is interesting. Alright, let's pull away the giant. That helps a bit. Wow, even with a whole row of goblins, they are still stronger than us. Interesting. Whoops. I just right-click delete because that's how I think it all works, but apparently not. There we go. Now it's a bit more balanced. Great. All right. Let's see what we got, right? All right. First battle. Woohoo! Excited. All right. We've got Kolex on, you know, we've got some heroes. I think those heroes really, really carved into our budget there. The purchase of the heroes. Oh, hello, Stealthy. What's up? I do have a perch for links, unfortunately. For bots and stuff. But do feel free to chat. Also because all my mods are nowhere to be found. Which is interesting. Then it is always handy to have a purchasing like that. No worries, Stealthy. Chatting is allowed. Chatting is allowed. Now, for those of you that don't know, I have not yet tried it with these settings. Now, I know my vid card is a bit of an ancient one. And this game might not run well. We'll see. We will see how well this game will run. Otherwise, we might have to lower the settings a bit. Oh man, look at this army. Holy crap, does it look awesome? Yeah. Super excited. There's some chosen with halberds there. Hacking into each other, clipping into each other, but still. There's Mr. Kolex Sun Eater himself. He's over there. Yep, that's him. Full of lightning and ready to go. The Dragon Ogre Shagat definitely looks different than the tabletop model, but equally scary. There's the Manticore guy. Exalted Hero with the Manticore. We've got Deadly Onslaught and Foe Seeker. We've got Kolex himself with Lord of the Storm, Deadly Onslaught, Foe Seeker, and Stand or Die. There's the Chaos Giant. Oh man, look at how he's animated, just awesome. Oh man, these look as ugly as they should. And then there's the Sorcerer here who has Arcane Conduit. Wait, he has no spells? Oh, the spells are in here. Flame Storm. Oh great, the spells are in front of my camera. And my camera is my camera screen is in front of the spells. Strong versus multiple units. Flaming Sword of Ruin. Weapon damage, cascading fire cloak, all pretty awesome. All right, so ooh, and the Hell Cannon, of course, with the Chaos Dwarfs, who do not have orange hair, interestingly enough. But there you go, very awesome. And I saw in the playthrough of the developers, yeah, that this was also animated. The corpse eating sacks of flesh. Alright. Let's get a solid front line in here. A solid front line of mortals, so to speak. Non-monstrous creatures. And then we have the hero line. Alright, so Let's pick up a flank that we want to attack from. Let's say we want to attack from the right flank, around the right, or maybe around the left. The hill looks kind of identical, so. Let's put them here. Oh wait, the Chaos Sorcerer needs to be behind as well, because that's ranged, of course. Is your game skipping or is the stream messing up? Wait, what's happening? I'm looking at my stream right now, at my preview window. What is skipping? What exactly do you ascribe as skipping? It looks to run fluently on my actual PC. So my game isn't really messing up in that sense. Alright, and we'll build the monstrous infantry line. Oh wait. We'll just put Kolek in the monstrous infantry line. We'll just go with that sort of thing. There we go. And then we'll put the great deal, it looks like it's jumping back a frame. It sort of slows down, it seems like, but not really jumping back in that sense. But I do see what you mean. It does slow down the just for a tinge, it slows down the scrolling. Zero, what's up, man? Long time no see, how have you been? Okay, we can put the Hellcannon a bit closer to the front lines. Man, turning siege weapons and siege equipment in Total War has never been a favorite activity of mine, just saying. Not sure if we can shoot past the hill, but maybe if we put it there. Alright, let's see what the greenskins are up to. You could move information like this, right? Yeah, there we go. The game is running smoothly for me so far, but I'm not sure yet. We haven't found the enemy army yet, so, you know, more models to render. Big Gray finished my mandatory military service. Nice, Zero, nice, awesome. Oh god. There are the greenskins. There we have the Arachnorok spider in the front. Everyone, halt! Open fire. How can an open fire? Oh, direct hit, I think. All right, what is good against single target? A fireball? Strong versus multiple combatants? Strong versus multiple? Not strike area, strong versus multiple? Only strong versus multiple units. Okay, they haven't come into range yet, but we are going to cast it, and hopefully it will hit something. There we go, cast! Zap! Right in the front lines. Alright, the Savage Orcs are charging in, we're counter-charging. Counter-charging with our Marauders there. Uh, Hell cannon, what are you doing? What are you doing? Why are you moving? Oh wait, it's a hell cannon, it's not a it's not a ranged unit, I forgot. Okay. So Kolek, can you come help with the spider? You're about to get close up with one, yeah. And I'm not very very fond of the spiders in the real world, so. Lord of the Storm, cost magical damage. Another strong versus multiple combatants. Well, maybe you can lightning up the archers there. Bam! Get lit up, archers. Kolek is getting up close and personal with an Arachnorok spider. Well, the butt of the Arachnorok spider. Okay, the knights are getting wrecked here, so we need to... You know what we're going to do? We're going to put the knights in the flanks here. We're going to put them here. And we're going to let the poison warhounds chase the chariot. That should do it. So the knights are coming in. Bam! Get charged. You are going to get... Is the cascading cloak, is that affects allies in range? Uh-oh. Grimgor Ironhide is coming for a mage. Reinforce our lord here as he's fighting Grimgor Ironhide. Alright, our lord is finding Grimgar Ironhide. Or more or less our Manticore is. Oh, he's getting charged by goblins. Luckily they are just goblins. Uh-oh. This flank is crumbling fast. Alright, Hellcannon, can you just destroy these archers please? Uh-oh. Oh, we still have a giant. Giant! I totally forgot about the lumbering giant. Alright, lumbering giant. Lumber into action, because... You need to, get into the thick of things. Alright, it does have some trouble sometimes, the graphics. And I zoom in mostly. Oh! Alright, buff up. Kolek, we've got to... I think this is not going well, guys. I think we might be doomed. Burning skull in there. Get the archers out of there. All the melee dudes. No, another fleeing chaos voice. Yes! Oh yeah. Oh god. Yep. Some archers are being eaten by the skull. Oh, the night goblins are tying up the cannon, not good. Alright. There's a big mashy melee here in the center. Oh! Woo! Victory! Nice, we got it. The day of chaos. Kolek is still munching on some goblins here. Wow, he barely survived. He's got what? He's got 1300 life left. He barely survived, but holy shit! A pyrrhic victory. The enemy has cost you dearly. Do you even deserve to call it a victory? Who knows? No one knows. But a victory, nonetheless. Ooh, Gringar Ironhide perished as well. No life left for that lord. But, yeah. That was quite a close fight there. Great, interesting. Alright, so first custom battle, success. First impressions? Excellent. Like, the feeling of the battles is definitely different than what you're used to Total War. What you're used from Total War. That's mostly in part due to the characters, I think, and the big monstrous units that we've been able to throw around. Another part is the magic. But a third part, that could also have been different in other Total Wars, is they kind of brought back the line cohesion from Rome 1, coupled with the we break and come back sort of fluency of Attila. So Attila Total War had units breaking more often, but also coming back to the fight more often, so you kind of got a sway into the battle. This game has that as well. And it also has, when two units engage, you know, the line stays like it was in Rome 1. The line stays. It doesn't, like, get all meshed together and all chaotic, like. And I think that is in part from, because the, it's what they said, because they removed the matched combat, so it's more like Medieval 2 nowadays, where you just have units whacking at each other, not really this fluent combat animation sort of thing going on, so there is that. But yeah, it feels really good. The commanding it and using the magic and all that sort of stuff feels really fluent. Feels really awesome. I am going to put down the graphics somewhat though, because I do think my PC is going to have... Yeah, look at that. It just put everything on ultra. Now I'm not the graphic most knowledgeable when it comes to graphics, but I think... If we will just, what will we put down? I think if we put down, there weren't really that many buildings, so I don't think that is the... I think putting down shadows is... Oh god, there's an extreme. Oh, only for shadows. I was like, there's an extreme option there. Holy shit. But I think if we just put shadow detail on high... yes, Wolf Cup, and it put this. It put this on, there is a setting, a find your, yeah, recommended setting. But when I pressed it, it put it on this. And I think it runs really, really well, especially if you consider Rome 2 release, which was just super terrible. Luckily, my PC ran it well, without too much problems right from the box. But I have heard some stories of the Rome 2 release being less than optimal. And this game just runs well. This is out of the box, unpatched, as we just found out. And it runs ultra. I mean, you see my settings or my computer specs down below the stream. But it's a GDX 780, which isn't the newest card in the rink, so to speak. And... it runs ultra. My CPU isn't the best CPU on the market. I bought this computer like 2 years ago, perhaps. I bought this computer when the GTX 780 was new. That's when I bought the computer. And it is, you know, it runs. It's not the newest computer on the market, but it runs ultra. And even though there were a few hitches there when the clash was actually happening, it didn't even bother me. It is insane how well this game is optimized. Like, in comparison to what they did with Roman stuff, this... Wow. But then again, after Rome, they couldn't have... they couldn't afford they couldn't afford another game as poorly optimized as Rome, of course, so... I'm sure they put a hell of a lot of effort into it to make sure that they wouldn't disappoint their fans a second time. But yeah, really cool. Alright, who is ready for the Vampire Counts campaign? Yeah, very nice. So I haven't seen this yet either, so this is the campaign selection screen. So I'm just gonna explore it a bit. So they've got... the movie here, this is what we saw in the Empire trailer. These are all images from the Empire trailer so far. They've got a description, it seems. Yep, just the description of the current situation in the world. And, you know, what needs to be done. There is some faction mechanics here. There is the RO mechanic, which I haven't tried out myself yet. It basically means some factions can factions can only capture a specific part of the world. You can't capture Dwarf Holds as the Empire, for example. People really got upset over it. I haven't read as many upset comments lately. When the game was out, I was reading the forums in America. When I was in America, and I haven't really read a thread that said RO really is as crappy as we thought it would be. So perhaps maybe RO isn't such a big deal. The realm occupation, for those that want to know who, or regional occupation is what it stands for. But yeah, maybe, who knows? Offices, oh, their special thing. The Empire has offices, granting them a unique title and bonuses. And how their technology tree works, as well as their victory objectives for long and, I guess, yep, short campaign. Exactly. There are quite a few objectives here, it seems. But, yeah, there's the top units, so these are the units you want to shoot for, of course. Steam tanks, demigryphs, and Luminog. And then you have a description of the playstyle. Confederation options, balanced unit roster, fractured empire, numerous enemies. You've got the dwarves here, with their grudges, of course. The slayers are their top units, gyro bombers and iron drakes. The greenskins here, with the fightiness rating and the animosity and the WOG, of course, with the Arachnorc spider that we just fought, the Doomdiver catapult and the giant. We have the Vampire Counts, which is what we're going to play today. We can only capture Vampire Count or human factions. We can raise the dead. And we need to spread corruption. But we're going to look at this in a bit more detail later on. And, or just in a bit. And of course we have the Warriors of Chaos, because this is the High King edition, so I do have the Warriors of Chaos DLC. And we have, some awesome stuff here. Hordes. They are the Horde faction, which is the only reason I'm not playing them instantly, is this little rule here, the Horde faction. And they spread corruption. But let's look at the Vampire Counts for a closer look, because this is the one we're going to be playing. Vargulfs, Terrorgeist and Hex Raids are the top units. We can raise the dead, of course. We can spread vampiric corruption. We have strong battle magic options. We have units cause fear. We have crumbling, which means that units die instead of rout. We have battle casualties are automatically raised from the dead post-battle, even in defeat. Very nice. And no missile units. The initial challenge is normal. And let's see about the story here. The vampires have ever been a plague upon the living, and none more so than the Von Karsteins, an abominable bloodline of undead nobles from the deathly realm of Sylvania. They inevitably strike out from this region at the head of a mighty undead host. Power-hungry necromancers, zombie hordes, ranks of skeletons, tomb-skulking crypt ghouls, and bestial vorgles are just some of the nightmares a vampire lord can summon to his indomitable will. Vlad was the Vlad was the primogenitor of the Von Karstein line, but Manfred was equally feared, finally being brought to bay at Helfen and slain. But what is no longer living is never easy to kill. Manfred has risen again. The dead have never rested easily in Sylvania, and now they lurch from their graves, summoned to unlive by the midnight aristocracy, as Manfred prepares to challenge mankind once more. He is the eternal emperor, the usurper, call friends, will learn at this at great cost, and all the living will pay tribute to Von Karstein's unholy majesty. Chaos Warriors Race seems to be a free DLC for everyone who buys the game in the first week. That is indeed true. By the way, are orcs even allowed to use words they can't spell? Not sure. Does that say so here? I don't see anything that they can't use. Alright, let's look at the objectives for the vampire counts. I think I'm going for a short campaign here. I guess I can go for a long campaign if all goes well. We need to maintain 12 provinces, either through direct ownership or through vessels and military allies. And I think even the ones that you can't count, can't conquer, you can still vassalize. Not sure about that one though. They have animosity, that is true. We need to destroy the empire. We need to ensure that the military presence belonging to the Warriors of Chaos faction exists only in the Chaos Wastes. And we need to ensure that Archaon the Ever-Chosen is in wounded state. That is a five-syllable word indeed, but I've never heard them pronounce it. Alright, so we can be Manfred von Karstein, the faction leader. He's a fighter and a wizard. Has access to both Law of Vampires and Law of Death. He has a 5% campaign movement range and a -10 upkeep for Grave Guard and Black Knight units. He starts with a Vargul, some bats, and a ghoul. Or some ghouls. Or we can be Heinrich Kemmler. He is a powerful wizard who masters the Law of Vampires. He has less raised death cost and a lesser upkeep for necromancer heroes. Starts with hex rates, chaos rates, and the direwolves. This is the guy who was searching for power and stuff, and this is the actual faction leader, Manfred. I think I'm going to start with him because he has some sort of introduction. Introductory battle and campaign tutorial. Might have to do that one. Can always count on Astral to dip into the latest in the war game. DJ Royster, what's up? Of course. If I could, I would have done a release stream, but then Creative Assembly decided to move the release date from April 28th to May 24th. And on May 24th, I was in San Francisco. So I was not able to actually do a release stream, which is unfortunate, but we are here now. I'm ready to get in there. We just, for those that just joined us, we did do a unpacking of the Hiking Edition. I've showed everything there is to see in the Hiking Edition. If you want to see that, I am going to YouTube/ highlight it on Twitch, so you will be able to see it afterwards. That will probably be tomorrow morning that I will do it and then load it up on YouTube. So you will be able to see it afterwards. If you want to see everything that the Hiking Edition contains, put it all in front of the camera, and yeah, you can see what's in there. Is that the seer? That is indeed the seer. We are about to jump into Warhammer to the Wall, Mr. Lanterns. You play these games all the time? Well, experience. Thank you, DJ, for the compliment. And yes, I've been a fan of the Total War franchise since Shogun 1, and I've been a fan of the Warhammer franchise since the 6th edition. My first army ever was the Vampire Counts. So I am really glad that the people chose the Vampire Counts for the poll, in which I asked my community which faction do you want to see me play first, because the Vampire Counts are my favorite faction and I am ready to jump in. I'm so excited. So yeah, let's read this and jump in, shall we? Before rising to his current power, Manfred von Karstein avoided the infighting of his peers and instead traveled far and wide, seeking to deepen his knowledge of the necromantic lore. He made unholy pilgrimages to ancient tombs and cities, where he wrested forbidden secrets from Bone Darai scrolls made from human skin, studied ancient spells in the first books of the dead, and struck foul bargains with powerful long-dead beings. When Manfred finally returned to Sylvania, he was more powerful than ever, and he took over the undead legions in the wake of his insane predecessor's destruction. Though previously he had traveled in the guise of an imperial lord, now at the height of his power, his appearance has become more horrifying. His face became contorted and corpse-like, and his scalp writhing with magical energy. Yet his newfound powers are not enough, and he thirsts for evermore as part of his designs for the imperial throne. Never heard of the Vamp Dwarf? Me neither. Royster, me neither. But then again, I am not the biggest knowledgeable guy on the lore, so perhaps, but nope, never heard of it myself. Not sure if dwarves can become vampires. Alright, let's do this. Today is a good day to be dead. There you go. We're getting a introductionary battle, so very excited to see that happen. I think dwarves are going to be very resistant to becoming a vampire, because it's sort of magical, it's sort of a magical process, and dwarves do have magic resistance, innate magic resistance, that's probably tied to their blood. Not sure exactly. These are all things that I'm just throwing out there, not actually knowing exactly what it is. But I think it's really hard to turn a dwarf into a vampire because of the magical resistance in their blood, I think. But that's speculation on my end, not being the most knowledgeable Warhammer lore guy that there is in the world. So, no idea. Video!
War is eternal. As inevitable as the grave. The old world, the rotting corpse within. Some fools think it worth saving. But there are beings who wish to bring about an eternal night. I am a bearer of lore, to those with such power. Manfred has returned from the dead once more. He marches on the von Karstein ancestral pile of Castle Dragonhof. For I have brought him ill news that a master necromancer has claimed the fortress as his own. Manfred must retake his ancient stronghold and either destroy the usurper within or bind him to his will.
And we jump straight into the battle.
Feeble wretch.
That's
come
cool.
Come hence from mine fortress and kneel before thy lord. Drakenhof stones are bound by mortar of mine own blood, while yours shall be sprayed across the battlefield as I wrench the head from thine shoulders.
Your forces begin their attack, my lord. See for yourself.
That's cool. They do have two moons, indeed true. Must be hell for werewolves. I'm not sure if there are werewolves in the Warhammer world, but again, not the biggest
be
lore
sure
guy.
Be sure to join the fight yourself. The warriors will be greatly inspired by your presence.
I cure his death. The death march.
All right, we're going to march. My grave guard here. Wow. Awesome.
These lands are mine.
And then Fred von Karstein here.
Attack.
Also very awesome. No,
remember,
coming outside.
As you fight, that help and advice is available at your request, my lord. You may rely upon it.
I like that it's also a pretty necromantic advisor, basically. It's really this old dude with the raven and is like, you know.
To battle! Join
very
the fray!
Awesome.
Show them that a von Karstein once again stalks Sylvania!
Charge! Oh wow, those graveguard are amazing.
The gift of death.
Really awesomely animated, look at that. Manfred is just hobbling along in his big cloak. Those spikes really seem to be unwieldy for someone who's just charging into the fight. Alright, here we go. Charge! Charge! Whack some skeletons. Get whacked. Get stabbed and... Hey, Green! Sup? Come on, Graveguard.
My souls linger. Harvest them.
Kill them. Thank you, Green. How have you been? I hope everything's been well in the world of Green Ankh.
The enemy begins to crumble. Press home your advantage. Grind them to dust.
Undead Ascendant. Anhel's Dance Macabre.
Anhel's Dance Macabre. I have to say though, they're jumping a lot. You haven't done your job, the USA is still there? That wasn't my job.
Be sure to take charge of the forces you control, sir. Effective command of your army is a skill worth mastering.
Alright. But all we have to do is just charge in, right? Fargolf in the front and center. Charge. Ooh. Another one with a lot of jumping animations. I think Creative Assembly really likes their jumps.
Slaughter them!
Do I have spells?
I serve me.
I do. The Gaze of Nagash. 4 the Horde. Wait, I'm not Chaos. I'm not a Horde faction. Alright. Fire! Ooh, that was a direct hit. Oh crap.
Your presence could sway the battle, sire. Your words and actions can inspire the troops before you. Use your influence and abilities.
What? Bring death!
Dwarves can have abilities? Yeah, I can see that, but I don't have any abilities. I've got my lord selected, but no abilities.
The heart of the city is within sight, my lord! Press forward!
Sylvania rules the night!
Is the game lagging? You too? Really? It's running smoothly for me. Is it really lagging on the on the stream? What's going on? I'm looking at my stream, my own stream, but not sure if it's lagging.
I hunger. Swift after.
It feels just fluent, but oh god, that will hit the building. Now he can fly.
Shows himself. Van Kruger joins the battle. He fights amidst his mounted troops.
Manfred von Karstein. They are cattle.
As the army charge, I'm just checking to see if I can. Maybe there's a little bit of jitteriness. Not sure. Maybe I need to turn down a few more settings. Not really sure. I'm still experimenting with the